Greetings again everyone, and today I'm testing out the latest in Sigma's new I series of lenses in all their distinctiveness, the 24mm f3.5 DGDN Contemporary. It's an autofocus full frame lens for Sony E-mount cameras and also L-mount mirrorless cameras, and I'd like to thank Sigma UK for providing a copy of this lens for testing, although as usual this is a totally independent review. 24mm on a full frame camera is a favourite focal length of mine, giving you a very wide, slightly dramatic field of view without quite creeping into the trickiness of ultra wide angle territory. It's really useful for street photography, landscape, architecture, and even wedding photography. The lens's maximum aperture of only f3.5 is far less encouraging, meaning it only lets in about as much light as many zoomable kit lenses do at 24mm. However, the idea of a prime lens like this is that it can be much smaller and hopefully offer better image quality, and sometimes, as is the case with this lens, they can let you shoot much closer to your subject. This particular one has an exceptionally close focus distance. It costs $550 in the US or £480 in the UK, a little on the pricey side for a prime lens of only a brightness of f3.5. Let's see what you're paying for here. Like other lenses in this series from Sigma, its build quality is something to behold. These really are some of the best designed and manufactured autofocus lenses you can buy. It's nice and small and only weighs 225 grams, but the body is entirely made of metal, tightly assembled, with a nice brushed finish. The rear mount is made of metal also and features a weather sealing gasket. The first control point is an aperture ring which clicks around very satisfyingly and with a good firmness, so you won't accidentally change your aperture. We also get an auto manual focus switch and a manual focus ring that turns incredibly smoothly and responds very precisely to being turned. The lens does exhibit some focus breathing, as you can see here, zooming in a little as you get closer to your subject, but it's only at its worst when you're focusing very closely. Autofocus speed isn't hugely important on a lens like this, but I found this lens's autofocus motor working quickly, silently, and accurately here. When it reaches its focus point, you can sometimes hear a quiet little clicking sound, but when shooting in video mode, that does go away. As well as a regular plastic lens cap, it also comes with something very unusual, a magnetic metal lens cap that attaches itself right onto the front. Sigma really thinking out of the box there. A magnetic lens cap holder will be available separately, which you can attach to your camera bag or elsewhere about your person. That could be an interesting solution for some people. I wonder if the idea ever catches on. This lens also comes with a very high quality metallic hood, which clips into position very firmly and looks the business. Its filter size is 55mm wide and it does not have image stabilization. Overall, the build quality of this particular lens really is on another level. Its rather rigid design aesthetic might not be to everyone's taste, although personally I think it looks cool, but there's no denying that handling this thing is a huge pleasure, and I especially like its very compact size. Much more important though is image quality, so let's start by mounting it onto a full frame camera, my 42MP Sony a7R II. In the middle of the image, straight from f3.5, we immediately see razor sharp image quality with excellent contrast, and over in the corners, they're a bit softer but still very good. Stop down to f5.6 and they're a little brighter and sharper, and at f8, the corner image quality is excellent. The lens tays this sharp down to f16 or f22, where the effects of diffraction begin to kick in and soften the image again. So, on a full frame camera, it's a very good performance here, with plenty of sharpness and contrast all around, although I was hoping perhaps for just a tiny bit more sharpness in those corners at the brightest apertures. Now let's see how it performs on an APS-C camera, my little 24MP Sony a5100. At f3.5, the lens continues to be pin sharp in the middle of the image with excellent contrast. The APS-C corners look better than the full frame ones, being virtually perfect themselves even at f3.5. They stay this sharp down to f11, although again, stop down any darker than that and softness will begin to emerge. So, if the lens was good on full frame, the APS-C performance is simply perfect. 10 out of 10 here. Now, let's take a look at distortion and vignetting on a full frame camera. Your camera will normally correct for these, but here are the true results without corrections. We see some heavy pincushion distortion in the corners, as well as a lot of darkness from vignetting. The corners brighten up at f5.6, f8 and f11, but there'll always be at least a little darkness there. So that's a major optical weakness of the tested lens, but then again, Sigma are actually very open about saying that these lenses are intended for use with in-camera corrections. Sacrificing this image quality does at least make it easier for them to keep the lens's size and weight down. Moving on, a pleasant surprise with this lens is how closely it can focus to your subject, down to an incredible 11cm, making it by far the closest focusing 24mm lens I've ever tested, giving you a 1:2 ratio magnification. That is enormously fun to experiment with if you can get enough light onto your subject when shooting up close. I needed to get out my test subject for macro lenses for this one. At f3.5, the close-up image quality is, well, it's terrible quite frankly, but you only need to stop down to f5.6 to be treated some excellent sharpness again. It stays this sharp down to f11, so that really is an awesome feature. Now, let's see how the lens works against bright lights. Top marks here. The smaller size of the glass elements inside it help it to sail through this test with barely any visible flaring at all. Finally, let's take a look at the quality of this lens's bokeh. It's not easy to get out of focus backgrounds with a wide-angle f3.5 lens. When you do, the good news is that they look lovely and soft, no problems here. Overall, well, this is a camera lens I wouldn't ordinarily get very excited about, a prime lens but one without a bright maximum aperture. But this neat little thing's excellent optics and addictively good build quality, as well as its very interesting near macro close focus distance, make it quite charming, and it's an enviable choice for any 24mm enthusiast, and 24mm is certainly a popular focal length. If you don't need a bright maximum aperture, then its price just about covers its quality. It's surely the 24mm lens for you, and it comes recommended.